So let's talk more about AI and where it's going, because your next guest is a guy, he's honestly one of the more interesting and definitely one of the smartest people I've ever had the privilege of meeting. He's also the author of a soon-to-be-released book called AI or Die. Why am I holding up the book when you got a graphic? AI or Die, a guide for business leaders and AI's impact on every aspect of our life, including finance, healthcare, education, and more. Jack Hidary is CEO of SandboxAQ, an AI and quantum computing company spun out of Alphabet last year, working to dramatically speed the time to market for drug discovery using massive amounts of computing power.
Brian,
is that correct? What I just said is directionally correct.
Directionally correct. AI for drug discovery, for new materials, for battery chemistry, for cyber. AI, and here's the point of the book, it's a do or die moment right now. And as you pointed out, yes, people look at the Magnificent Seven. Okay, recently, last few days, we had Microsoft earnings, we had Google earnings, we had Amazon earnings fueled by AI. The question, Brian, is how about the Fortune 500? How about the Global 1000? Right now, the next 24 months is going to be a do or die moment for them. Are the pharma companies going to use AI? Are the automotive companies going to use AI? Are the energy companies going to use AI? There's going to be winners.
The answer is yes, though.
And losers.
But you know, this is what your book is about, Chapter 11, implementing AI in your business. All these CEOs right now are like, I know how to run a train company. I don't know anything about AI. What do I do?
Yeah. And Brian, here's what's happening. If you, as an investor, ask the management teams of the biggest companies, are you using AI in all these different sectors? They'll say, sure we are. But then you dig a little deeper. You find out, oh, yeah, they're using AI to cut customer service costs. Great. They're using AI to generate marketing copy for the website. Great. But how about deeper in the company? The key is, can you use AI to transform how you develop your products, how you design the next car or airplane, how you design the drug? Right now, drug discovery takes 10, 15 years, 90% failure in clinical trials. That's the pharma companies today. There's going to be a handful of them that will be winners who will use AI to leapfrog those numbers and say, we're going to get to market faster, we're going to increase success rates, and we're going to have more profit.
And I would imagine those companies that are going to be winners are those pharmaceutical companies that will use a company, SandboxAQ.
You got it.
Right, because that's what you've been on before, and that's what you're going to do. Instead of this 10 years using humans, a lot of people get sick.
Yep.
Some people die. You're testing all this stuff on human beings.
Right.
Being able to use massive quantum computing power to replicate the immune system.
Create a
and
virtual
reaction.
Human. Exactly, Brian. Create a virtual human using AI simulation, using the same GPUs we've talked about NVIDIA. We talked about NVIDIA before the big run-up. And so NVIDIA is the chip that is powering this, and we can create that AI simulation on those
quickly,
chips.
Will we have the electricity to power all these data centers, to power SandboxAQ?
We need to use AI in the energy sector to create a new kind of grid. That's what we need.
I love it. The book is out in a couple of months, AI or Die, a guide for leaders. And I want to say 100% of the revenue, not profits, all the revenue, every dime.
Educational charity.
Is going to educational charity. That is good work.
Thank you,
Jack
Brian.
Hidary, thank you very much.